작가님 고생과 박대 많이 오셨습니다. 아, 마 파티 난리야 목구멍이 멋있다니 마 파티 나를 마음으로 보이십니다. brother, sister, we just want to greet our visitor, that's our sister Akili Dila Rosario. Siya po ay she's invited by Martin Dila Cruz. He is invited by our brother Samuel. Allow brother sister, I will start our Bible study. Just want to call our brother Marvin.
Salamat sa iyo, Panginoon, Lord, sa biyaya kami na tama, Panginoon, sa kapayapaan na bibigyan sa amin, Panginoon, Lord, na pinahin ko, Panginoon. Isa pa, Panginoon, Lord, dahil ko, Panginoon, yung isang, Panginoon, at ang Panginoon, sa iyo, Panginoon, makasama, Panginoon, sa iyong lahat, at presensya, Panginoon. Lord, bibigyan po kami, Panginoon, Lord, open our hearts and understanding, Panginoon, at na hindi kami mag-relay, Panginoon, sa aming sarili, pero makakasin lang, Lord, kundi, Panginoon, sa iyong banal na sa iyong Panginoon. Isa pa, Panginoon, Lord, pwede sa Bible study to you, O Lord, in the precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Can we open the Bible in John chapter 14 and 18? I will not leave you comfortless, I will come to you. Amen. Just upon the alam of Father Sakhani Saita, please be all be seated. Thank you, Lord, sa panibagong blessing of you sa ating Panginoon. Una-una, I would like to share about maybe, alam niyo na to sa palayo, it's all about Sabbath. So, our topic for today is about Sabbath. So, many Christians work today, they rely on the day. So, they rely on worship day. So, he's saying about the day, it is Friday, because in the Jewish tradition, it should be Friday at 6 o'clock in the evening. Because it's the evening time, he said. So, in Seventh-day Adventists, they rely also on the Sabbath, which is the Saturday. Means Sabbath means Saturday for them. So, we're going to talk about what's really about the Sabbath means.
Amen.
First, we need to know who is the Sabbath. So, where its original came from. First, God is eternal, right? God is eternal. So, God wants to distribute His attributes. What can you use the second slide, please. So, sabi dito, God wants to display His attributes to become in order to be a God. So, una, He's a creator. Creator. Savior. Healer, provider, peace, omnipresent, omniscient. We know God is a spirit, so He needs to display His all attributes. That's why He wants to display all of this. So, we go now from the very beginning, how did He create in the Garden of Eden on the first day. So the first thing we find out here, heaven and earth, firmament, dry land, second day, third day, earth and sea, day and night, means today we're living now, the fishes of the sea. Also piece of the field. And his final creation is the image of God. Which is a man, this very common, and quoted by the pressure. Now, in the seventh day, means rest. What's meaning, what is rest, and what happening on that seventh day? So, sabi sa atin na minsan, hindi lang sila mismo nagre-relax doon na spending ng Eve. There's something happened in the Garden of Eden, or we know it is eternal. So it means there's no time coming yet, but it's eternal life here, inside the Garden of Eden. So sabi sa atin na minsan, when man fellowship with God on the seventh day. Now, in the beginning, when God came down in the evening and talked to Adam and Eve in the cool, the cool of the day, and his great voice whispered to them, and they had fellowship, loved one another, how the moving of the Spirit went through the bushes, the lions came up, the tigers, and all of them, they worshipped the Lord. Man consciously at all times that his presence was with him. So, in that seventh day, meron na pala nag-worship. Kasi niya, on the seventh day, there's a worship. It is eternal life in them. Seventh day. So when the sin came in, nagkaroon ng separation. When God, ang Panginoon before, nag-consent siya, may pag-fellowship siya nito, kina Adam and Eve. So when the sin came in, there's a gap between man and God. So, yung eternal life, hindi siya totally nawala. It's been held. It goes back to the original honor which from God. So yung eternal life, yan hawak na ngayon ng Panginoon. So nagkaroon ng mismo ng gap between God and man. Sin came in, separation came in, death came in. So, we go back again after Adam until the time of Abraham, until the time of Moses. So, the Lord commanded Moses on the seventh day, it's under the law, Exodus 16:23, and he said unto them, this is what which the Lord had said, tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath unto the Lord. Bake that which ye bake today, that seed that ye will see, and that which remain overlay upon for you to be kept until the morning. So sinabi dito kay Moses, gawin nyo na lahat, do everything on the sixth day. On the seventh day, there shall not be work at all. So means there's a peace. That's why until today, in the Jewish tradition, we celebrating Shabbat Shalom. Means there's no work at all. All the Jewish not going to work because it's forbid to them to work. So, after that, remember, nung dumating si Lord dito, at pinangalan ito ni Apostle Pablo, he said, therefore, by the deeds of the law, there shall no justified in flesh be his sight. For by the law is the knowledge of sin. So which means, in this Levitical law, under the Moses' time, their sin existed. What is sin? We know that sin is unbelief.
That's right.
But before that, God said in Book of Isaiah, "For all tables are full of vomit, filthiness, so there is no place to bring. Whom shall he teach knowledge, and whom shall he make to understand the doctrine? Them I weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast of precept must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little and there a little. For with a stammering lips and another tongue, he spake to his people, to whom he said, This is the rest, Sabbath, wherewithin he may cause the weary to rest, or keeping his Sabbath, to his refreshing that he will be here." Which means, upon all nito, they continue on sinning and sinning. Remember before Bible study, regarding for the tabernacle, yearly the offering, the sacrifices. At the same time, nagsawa ng Panginoon. He said, "Once and for all, I will come down to end the law." Yes, he will not break the law, but he fulfill the law.
Amen.
So, ang panibago ulit, ang Panginoon nag-consent ulit. He went with the body of flesh, which name called Jesus. So that's why in 1 Timothy 3:16, without controversy, God manifested in flesh. Then, ang Panginoon nag-offer sa kanila. Alalahanin natin, ang panahon ng Panginoon is concentrated on the people, on His people, which the Israelites. So, He don't care about the Gentile at all.
That's right.
So, how we receive this rest or continuing Sabbath is at the invitation of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said in Matthew 11:20-29, "Come unto me, all ye that labor are heavily laden, and I will give you rest.
Yes,
take my yoke upon you and learn on me. And ye shall find rest or keeping of the Sabbath, not a day, but eternal life Sabbath unto your soul."
That's right.
So, the corona invitation on in the time of the Lord Jesus Christ and the Jewish people, they cannot understand by the Lord what he's going to tell. Because the Lord is talking about spiritually, and the rabbis and the Pharisees are talking naturally, so they cannot meet at all. Why? Something between the light here and the Lord Jesus. Amen. So, how can we receive the Sabbath? For we know the Sabbath is not a day. He said here, it is not the day of worship, it's not the day of Friday or Saturday, Sunday. So how can we receive the Sabbath? He said here in Acts 2:38, prepares him us to believe.
Amen.
And accept it. And do what he said. Then Peter said unto them, "Repent and be baptized from every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost."
Yes, right.
So, pabalik ako lang po ang ulit, it's the seventh day ulit. So, what is the Sabbath means? It is the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
It is the new birth of each and every one of us. Amen. You must be born again. Kaya yes. Sinabi ng Panginoon din ng Nicodemus, you cannot enter the kingdom of God until you be born again. Born again experience is not about clapping hands and rising up the hand.
No.
It's a personal experience with God.
Yes, yeah. Right.
You need to be baptized in the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
So he said here in Hebrews 4:8, "For if Jesus had given them rest or rest day, then he would not afterward have spoken for another day."
That's true, amen.
"There remained therefore a rest, a Sabbath keeping to the people of God. For he that is entered into his rest, he also that hath ceased from his own works God did for His. So, wala ka nang ginawa, kundi gagawin mo na lang isa, maniwala at accept. Yun na lang ang gagawin mo, paniwala mo na lang, at tanggapin ang Panginoon, and He will baptize you with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So, that's why binasa natin kanina, personally, He said unto us, I will not leave you comfortless, I will come to you.
Yes.
Means personal, He will come. Individual of us.
Amen.
And in the prophet Isaiah, here, that we read before, it's about 700 years until the Lord came in the body of flesh. So he said here, here it's prophesied right there in Isaiah. And there it came to pass about 700 years at the Pentecost. So which means Isaiah to Acts? Acts 2. When they all filled with the Holy Ghost exactly as it was said they would be. This is the true Sabbath that was promised. Thus when they filled with the Holy Ghost, they cease from their worldly works, their worldly doings, their evil ways. The Holy Ghost took charge of their lives. They enter into rest, their inner rest, that is your Sabbath. It is not a day, not a year, but eternity of being filled and blessed with the Holy Ghost. Amen. It is you ceasing and God doing. It is God in you, willing and doing of His good pleasure.
Amen.
So which means, yung mismong eternal life na nahod ng Panginoon, na kinuha ka na ay Adam at Eve, ibinigay ngayon sa atin. Sa panahon natin, we are in the seven ages. As you can see here, alongside the seven ages. So God always perfect in number 777.
Right, yeah.
So, in our time, nagkaroon mismo ng baptism of the Holy Ghost. Yes, sa panahon na yun, hindi pa alam ng denomination, na-restore, nagkaroon ng restoration.
That's right.
Kaya sa panahon ni Paul, hanggang sa panahon natin, nagkaroon ng restoration time.
That's right, amen.
Then, the most of them go to church on Sunday,
mm-hmm.
That is good, but even there have no idea how to approach God.
That's true.
And how to worship Him. That's why in John 4:24, Jesus said, the true worship was in spirit and in truth.
Yes.
So which means there's a true worshiper in the spirit and truth. So how did Jesus say he's a true worshiper? Which means there's a false worshiper also.
That's true.
So that's why, but when turns to the Lord and is filled with Holy Ghost, he sees from all such things. He has a rest in his soul. He really begins to live and love God and worship
Amen.
Him.
Amen.
So yung mismo mga kabigatan natin na dinadala, yeah, like sinasabi sa atin ng Panginoon, eh, ibigay natin lahat ng kabigatan at maglibo tayo sa Panginoon.
That's right. Amen.
So, what is the Sabbath in the New Testament? The Sabbath, as we know it from the New Testament, is not keeping of a certain day.
Yes.
We have no commandment whatsoever to keep Saturday or Sabbath, nor do we have commandments to keep first day to week, which is Sunday as Sabbath. Many people keep days. Others make Sunday an idol, a worship day. Others make Saturday as a worship day. Both Sunday and worshiper and the Sabbath keeper are absolutely wrong.
Yes.
According to the Word of God, Sabbath to Christian is no longer keeping of holy days.
That's right.
New moon or season, it means eternal rest.
Amen. Rest.
To one soul by the new birth. We have to go by the Word of God, not of the Adventist say, nor by what the Pentecostals say, nor by the Catholics say. Now, there's something I know, questioning on why are we here? Remember, we are baptized in the Holy Ghost under His inspiration. As you can read in the Hebrews 10:25, we're just fulfilling what God said here. Hebrews 10:25. Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together as matter of some is, but exhorting one another and watch the more as you see day approaching, which means huwag yung pababayaan yung pag-ipon ng mga banal. Kaya tayo nandito dahil ito yung privilege na binigay sa atin ng
Panginoon.
But it is not a day, but it's the privilege of the Holy Ghost giving unto us to worship Him. Yung pagkakataon, mag-worship tayo araw-araw.
Yes, amen.
Right.
Amen.